Hey guys, so today I want to tell a really interesting story about the time I got stranded by my mother at Walmart. Now, a little bit of precursor, we lived about a mile and a half from the Walmart when I was growing up. And I was a pretty angsty, belligerent teenager. And we'd had a few occasions before where we were going to Walmart and my sister and I would go off to like the music section, listen to some Avril Lavigne, or we'd go look at the clothes while my mom went shopping for groceries. And my mom always said, like, meet me here in 30 minutes. And sometimes, I'll be very honest, we would be a little late because we were listening to the new Linkin Park song or some more Avril Lavigne or Evanescence. Those were like my top three favorite bands in high school. So one time, my sister and I headed off to listen to music in Walmart, and my mom headed off to the grocery section to get our groceries for the week. And we were listening to music, and the time came for us to go and meet my mom, and we didn't go. So we were like, whatever, she'll come find us or page us over the intercom. We were not going to go meet her until she had to leave. Well, 20 minutes passed, and she didn't page us, and she didn't find us. 10 more minutes passed, and we're like, maybe something's wrong, and we should go find her. So we go to the front where we were supposed to meet our mom, and she's not there. We go through the grocery aisle where we were supposed to meet our mom, and she is not there. We page her over the intercom, and nobody comes, and she is not there. I will say I was about 15 or 16, and my sister's 2 years younger. So we were not little children. Like, we're not little children who've lost their mother. We're teenagers. So there's a payphone in the Walmart, and I have a few quarters in my pocket. So I dial our home. And my mom picks up, and she basically said that she left us at Walmart alone because she was sick and tired of us not being where she asked us to be when she asked us to be there. And I remember just being completely shocked. I was shocked. I think my mom got a little bit fed up of us not showing up and her having to come looking for us before she went to pay for her groceries. But now looking back, I really think I got my just desserts. Because I was never late again when my mom asked me to meet her for grocery shopping. And I will say that my sister and I had walked to this Walmart several times, like over the summers and everything, because it was the only place to go, the only thing to do in our town. So we knew the way to and from Walmart. It took a while to get there. It was like a mile and a half to 2 miles. So my sister and I had to walk all the way home from Walmart. It was a very quiet, very remorse walk. Let me tell you that. I really don't fault my mom. Now, I would never leave my own children at Walmart. I mean, they're 3 and 4 months old. When you're faced with a teenager that doesn't listen to you and you're at your wit's end and you've reminded them several times and it's been several occasions, sometimes you go to drastic measures. So are there any other 90s kids that watch me that had this happen to them? Because I feel like this was a regular thing.